Mr. President, we are making this right of reply in response to India's statement. We regret that instead of introspection of its atrocities against the Kashmiri people, India has again resorted to baseless polemic and rhetoric against Pakistan. Pakistan wishes to remind India of the following undeniable facts. Jammu and Kashmir is recognized as a disputed territory by the international community and the United Nations Security Council resolutions and displayed accordingly in all legally recognized maps of the world. Since the disposition of Jammu and Kashmir is to be decided by its people through a UN-supervised plebiscite, India's forcible annexation of the territory in 1947 and subsequent occupation has no legal basis. Jammu and Kashmir is not part of India, and neither it has ever been. Commenting on Kashmir is therefore not interference in India's internal affairs. As a dispute on agenda of the United Nations Security Council, on which all principal organs of the UN are seized off, any report or document from the UN has to be considered in its relevant bodies and processes. In that sense, the UN, the regional and other international organizations like the OIC have a definite stake in the situation in Kashmir. In the same spirit, the OHCHR report on Kashmir needs a follow-up in the Human Rights Council. The report has shown India's true face to the world, a face India does not want the world to see. Pakistan has welcomed the OHCHR's recommendation of establishing a commission of inquiry. If India has committed no crime in Kashmir, and if sources of instability in Kashmir are external, India should also welcome the commission. India's abject rejection of the commission is a testament that it fears an independent investigation which will inevitably expose its crimes against the Kashmiri people. The OHCHR report neither legitimizes terrorism nor is an affront to global consensus on terrorism. The impunity enjoyed by the Indian forces and the resulting human rights abuse of Kashmiri people cannot be justified on the logic of terrorism. Hundreds of Kashmiri civilians blinded by pellet guns were not terrorists. Thousands of protesters who thronged the streets in towns and villages in Indian-occupied Kashmir are not terrorists. 8-year-old girl Asifa, raped to death by priests and extremists in a Hindu temple in Jammu, was not a terrorist. She, like all victims of sexual violence by India in Kashmir, awaits justice. Instead of punishing the rapists of little Asifa, the Hindu extremists made a political cause in their favor. This is symptomatic to a wider drift of India towards extremism and rank communalism. Where else on this planet except in India can an individual be lynched to death for carrying beef? Christians and Dalits, or the so-called untouchables, also bear the brunt of the extremist wrath. According to Persecution Relief, on an average, every day, at least one member of clergy is beaten to death and a church or his house is vandalized.
I thank you very much, madam. Time is up.